We're in Regent Central. This is Chiltern-Mt Pilot National Park, and we're here at this time of the year, just into autumn, because this forest at this time of the year flowers, and that's the key resource for winter autumn flowering species of ironbark and white box, and that's when Regent Honeyeater are best suited for this country. Acknowledging the traditional owners of the country in which we meet and pay our respects.
So the program we've got running here is a part of the National Regent Honeyeater Recovery effort, but this part is a captive release program that forms part of our ongoing recovery work for the species, and we're releasing birds back into the Chiltern-Mt Pilot National Park to try and help stabilise the population in the wild.
It's the fourth and the largest release of captive bred Regent Honeyeaters, and it's principally to help keep a critical mass and build a viable population base for a sustainable future for the species.
There are species which is critically endangered, which on the scale of how threatened something is, it's one step from being extinct in the wild.
Regents have declined to the point where they are now critically endangered, and it's largely a historical legacy of the settlement of the more fertile parts of the landscape. Our agricultural land, which carries the better soils, is the very areas which used to support probably the better environment for the species. So they're suffering from having that fragmented and barren landscape in some areas. And there's also now in that fragmented landscape, a lot of competition with aggressive and competitive honeyeater species and their native species, which are doing well in those fragmented alien environments. Noisy fry birds, but particularly noisy binder birds, which can be a real bully boy in that fragmented environment.
So to address this, we're implementing a pilot noisy minder control program, reducing the numbers in critical areas on the edge of the park in conjunction with landholders in that area.
Leading up to the release is quite involved. We sit with people and work out what's the best pairing firstly. We try and improve the genetic diversity of the birds that we release, and of course, the birds that we keep back in captivity.
It's really 2 years in the planning to get a release like this happening. So as soon as this release finishes, Tarongal will start planning for the next release.
Whilst these birds aren't too difficult to breed, they're not the easiest. You have to know the specifics about the species, and you have to be willing to put the extra effort in.
So the birds came down from Taronga Zoo 2 days ago. We had about half of them that we fitted with transmitters. We give them a day in the tent in between to get acclimatised to the local environment. We provide them some food, so we take some blossom out of the trees and put them in the tents to get them used to what they're going to be feeding. And then this morning we open the tents and we let the birds go. It's an enormous amount of work that goes into a release like this, and when the birds come out of the tent, it's a real wave of emotions. It's relief and excitement all packaged together.
Yeah, each of the birds have got their own bling, so they've got their own set of uniquely coloured leg bands so that we can individually identify each one, and we can get ourselves to those through the tracking of individuals. So we've got half of the released birds have got radio transmitters, and we've got a wonderful volunteer community which is going to help us to monitor the survival and movements, and ultimately hopefully find that these birds are breeding. Today is just the pinnacle, and funnily enough, it's only the start. It means it signals the commencement of a longer term monitoring program. We're going to have a really intensive 3 month period, but hopefully we see these birds in the environment for the next 10 to 12 years.
It's fantastic. It's one of the best parts of my job to be able to see a flock of Regent Honeyeaters leave the tents like that. It's nervous excitement. You're always a little bit worried about what they're going to encounter when they get out there and whether the conditions are right. It's turning back the clock. This is exactly how Regent Honeyeater experiences would have been decades ago. So it's a really positive thing to see.
This is a fantastic collaboration between a whole lot of organisations and importantly community. We've got the support and interest of a broad range of groups, from Friends of Parks, the Chiltern-Mt Pilot National Park, Landcare community, birders throughout the northeast, and BirdLife Australia clubs, and a heap of individuals. And then that's backed up by a whole lot of fantastic work from agencies such as BirdLife Australia, in collaboration with Taronga Zoo, who are critical in terms of the breeding, and of course including ourselves with DELP.
many birds have we had called in so far today?
Today we've had two transmitter birds and one non-transmitter bird. The non-transmitter bird hadn't been detected in the last couple of days, so that's an advance.
It's an amazing feeling being able to come here and let the birds go this morning when we open up the tents and half a dozen of them fluttered out almost straight away. Just seeing the black and yellow shoot through the forest, in contrast with the green, landing in the trees nearby and then taking off, it's almost, you almost get the butterfly feeling in your tummy.